Okay. On the couch. Say, have they not seen my ass?
We mentioned the back one. Oh, sorry.
There's room for all of us.
A rose between two thorns.
So cozy.
Right, the way this works is these guys are going to ask us some questions.
I've never done a right with you, Tony, before.
You can answer them.
We're there.
Right, okay, so the idea is that you stick your hand, there's a lot of people out there, I was expecting not people. If you've got questions, stick your hand in the air, and we've got a roving mic.
You guys don't have any questions.
John, identify yourself.
Nice to meet everyone. I'm just not comfortable. Sorry.
Oh, right. So if you can point to somebody who you think, I'd like to do that question.
You're so manly.
It's better. What?
You're so manly and in charge.
The opposite of my existence on the show.
Let's kick this off.
Are you guys excited to be here at this Comic-Con? Are you guys sad that James had to cancel?
Yeah.
But you're happy we're here, right? Okay.
All right, time for our first question. Ask away, please.
Hi guys, thanks for coming. Just want to say,
wait, where are you?
I'm here.
Stand up.
Wait.
Yes.
Stand up.
Show yourself.
I was just wondering, Cars Buffy is one of those shows that kind of influences.
You better stand up while you're talking. Cosplay from The Walking Dead?
Stranger Things.
Stranger Things.
It's the same thing.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Now hop on one leg as you ask the question.
I'm just
going to finish this Instagram while you're.
Okay.
Buffy is one of those shows.
Don't shut up now, really.
Buffy is one of those shows. Are you sad Sean had to cancel?
I'll just have my coffee, that's fine.
Okay.
Buffy is one of those shows that was like massively influential. You can still see the influence in other things today. I was just wondering, either have you seen anything that you think was in like another TV show, or that you think was inspired by Buffy, or has someone come up to you, or maybe a famous person, and said that they loved the show, or an influenced by it, or anything like that? Just any interesting story you might have about the impact and the legacy of
in the world.
I'm being vague. Yes.
Good. That's my contribution.
So articulate.
You know what, though? You are correct. Buffy was sort of the beginning of the strong female lead who was also flawed. And so over the years, that theme has been taken to many different levels, including Stranger Things. And it's definitely grown and become more commonplace. I think Buffy was the first show that sort of allowed that flawed teenage female character to be strong and also accessible to young and old women, older women. And yeah, definitely in my time meeting different people who are also in the business, a lot of people are very passionate about that show, just like you guys. So there's a reason that you guys are still here in this audience today, and the show has far-reaching, you know, extensions.
Yeah, and I think a lot of it had to do, too, with the relatability, because, I mean, you can go back to Wonder Woman and Bionic Woman and other quote-unquote supergirl-type, superhero-type shows before Buffy, but those, to me, weren't grounded in a reality that was so relatable to us commoners. And so I think that was the thing that kind of got your hooks into the show emotionally and was a jumping-off point where you could say, that could be me, as opposed to Wonder Woman, which was a bigger stretch to say, that really is not me, I do not have a rope that can do that.
For some of us, that's a bigger stretch. Yeah.
Who's in the tall chair?
You're there for now. We'll see.
I've had many experiences, but one of the best ones was going in to meet Shonda Rhimes and the first time, and I went to their office, and they all genuflected. Said,
child!
This is good. basically said, because they were all writers, and they all said that they'd all come up through, you know, the years of Buffy, and it had established, because it's great writing. It's still, you know, still now I look at the script and think, I wish they were writing it. not always, but you know, it's Joss. It's a great legacy. He is an amazing writer.
I have to say one of the things. I just finished my directorial feature debut, and what was very Gary Oldman has an extended cameo in it, and Joss has a cameo in it, and we did a photo shoot with them on set together. And watching Gary actually totally fanboy out with Joss was so cute. And he came up to Joss in the makeup room, and he was like, "So I really, really, really loved Much Ado About Nothing." And he was like, "And I really, really loved Buffy." And Joss was like, "Oh my God, it's Gary Oldman."
Thank you very much, guys. Great to have such a range of characters here today. So thanks. I'm still here.